Welcome to Wild Things Sanctuary. I'd like to invite you in to see what Wild Things does. Come on in. Wild Things Sanctuary is a wildlife rehabilitation center based in upstate New York. Its goal is to rehabilitate and look after injured, sick, orphaned animals of all different kinds of wildlife and to eventually return them to the wild. This is a very busy time of year, springtime. We get a lot of babies in, very, very busy. And I just thought, introduce you to some of the patients. You never know what's going to come in the door when somebody arrives. At the moment, nobody, thankfully, because it's been very busy. But we get all different kinds of animals with all different kinds of injuries. So it'll just give you a little idea of who we get. Here we've got a very young crow who was found in the woods surrounded by beehives, actually. And was all by himself, was clearly, there was no parents in sight, and his leg was injured. It looked like maybe a little fracture. The rescuer was very brave, went through the bees and brought him to Wild Things. He's doing really well. He's been on anti-inflammatory painkillers for his foot, which is slowly healing, and he's eating very well. It took almost a week to get him to open his mouth for me, so this good behavior wasn't happening up until 2 days ago. I was keeping him in a cage, but he's decided that his best friends, and it just makes him much happier, are the little mallard ducklings. So I let him sit on the cage during the day. If you can look in there, you can see I've got four little mallard ducklings. They're about a month old. He wants to be more friendly with them than they really want to be with him, but what can you do? That sometimes happens. These are two little possums in here.
Oh boy. Yeah.
They look small, but they can still bite you pretty good at that size. They were brought into somebody's house by their cat, and they had minor injuries, but they were just really small, really unusual. They were born obviously very early in the year, maybe as early as the end of January, beginning of February. And I'm just gonna keep them here till they get a little bit bigger and more self-sufficient. We'll just let them go on their own then. And here we have two little baby girl groundhogs. These two little whistle pigs, as they're also called, or woodchucks. Their mother was trapped and relocated, and then these two little babies crawled out of the burrow. They can be a little temperamental. You can see they're incredibly creative at redesigning their cage. So today they've taken their house, turned it on the side, appear to be sleeping in it, and have also thrown everything they possibly can into their water. So it's sort of always fun just keeping up with everybody's cleanliness regimes and everything like that. Hey, girls. Hi. Here we have the squirrel cages. At the moment I've got six squirrels. They're all about 3 months old and they're about to be released. I keep them until they're that age to make sure they have enough formula, just really give them the formula until they're about 12 to 14 weeks old, because they can really get bad deficiencies with calcium and things like that. But they're all in great health. Ordinarily I'd be letting them run around the room, but we have other plans for today. So keep them in there. Oh, look, she's burying her nut. Oh, bury it. Nobody's gonna find it.
Where did it go?
Oh, I don't know. Anyway, in this cage over here, now these guys are sort of nocturnal, so a lot of times you don't see them during the day. We have got the baby bunny section. So baby bunnies, for anybody who's ever looked after baby bunnies, they're probably one of the hardest animals to keep alive in rehabilitation when you get them really young. So there was actually quite a few more to begin with, and a few of them didn't make it. They got here and they were pretty starved. But the ones that did are doing great. They're going to be released soon, so that's all good. Here we've got a little young raccoon. Now, I keep all of my rabies vector species, raccoon, skunks, and bats, in a separate area, but I've just brought them in just for a brief time period to weigh them this evening, and you all wanted to take a look at them, but ordinarily they're kept in a strict different area, and they will be brought down there right afterwards. Anyway, this little girl came in just the other day. I'm not gonna hold her because you need to have gloves, and I don't have my gloves with me. She's doing pretty well. She actually came in, she had maggots in her eyes. She was doing very, very starved and just really abandoned. Seemed to have gotten all the maggots out of her eyes, which was a good thing. But what does concern me is that she's got scabs all around her neck, possibly indicating that she was bitten, and possibly indicating, you never know what could have attacked her. Maybe it was a rabid animal. So she'll be kept in isolation for at least 2 weeks probably more, just to make sure that she's okay. In here, another little rabies vector species that, again, will go back to its separate little area. This is a young skunk. Let me get loose.
Oh.
He still has to open to eyes, but he's a real cute little bugger. And they can actually spray as soon as they're born.
So oh, wow.
Gotta respect them a little bit. So just a few more. Got another little raccoon. This one's very healthy. And as soon as he knows we're looking at him, he's gonna start crying. Yeah, because as soon as they're like having children. Everybody's like, oh my god, they're so cute. And you're like, they're a lot to look after. And then this is the newest patient. This is a little chipmunk. Somebody had been trying to look after it. It inhaled formula into its lungs and got pneumonia. So I'm treating it with antibiotics, with warmth, and rehydrating it. So hopefully within the next few days, it should make a turnaround. But finally, and the reason why you are here today, we're actually gonna be relocating a couple of animals to an outdoor area, which me and my friend set up this morning. And it's these two guys. Hi.
Oh.
These are two fawns. Fawns are also very difficult to rehabilitate, but they came to me in different ways. This one, somebody stole from her mother, which is awful. And this one has a broken foot, which I have a special splint on so it can stand up without touching its hoof on the ground. Anyway, we're gonna take them outside.
A deer has gotten away, a baby deer, and there she is. Close. Just another day in the life.
Just another day at Wild Pig Sanctuary. It's great. There's over 100 acres here of woods, and it's a really nice place to be able to let them go after they're all better. So this is their new outdoor pen. This one looks like he's a little bit nervous. Hey, sweetheart. We took another cage here. And we just laced different kinds of browse that they like. We've got maple, which is one of their favorites. I think this is some kind of hawthorn. I'm not the plant expert. Some grape leaves, some apple twigs, all stuff that they like to browse on. And hopefully they're gonna start browsing soon because that helps their digestion. It's really touch and go with these guys. But so far so good. So we'll see how it works. They'll probably be here for another few weeks and then slowly, I'll just let them start wandering around the woods, and they usually come back for feedings throughout the day. They're both about a week old.
Very nice. Best of luck to you guys.
Well, just when you think you have a minute to yourself, another call comes in, and there's another animal to be rescued. This time, it's a duck in somebody's yard that appears to have some sort of broken wing. I asked them if they could corner... Just a minute, this is probably them. Hi. Great. Fantastic. Well, I'm just getting the car. I'll be right there. Great. Thank you. They managed to get the duck in a box because I didn't want to drive 20 miles away and they're like, the duck's gone. The duck is ready for me to go pick up and it's off on another wildlife rescue mission. If you really want to help wildlife, make a donation to Wild Things Sanctuary. Please consider it and take a look at my website. wildthingssanctuary.org.
Wild thing, I think I love you.